Slick, how long is this going to take? I'm a little busy at the moment.
You're busy, huh? You're always busy, especially when I need you. That's when you're always busy. Well, I'm going to give you four reasons to get yourself unbusy, okay?
Okay.
One, you're on retainer. Two, I need you. Three, you love me.
Well, Slick, that's only three reasons.
Find the time or you're fired.
Oh. Oh, I like four. I mean, one through three are very impressive, but four is definitely my favorite.
Good, excellent. Congratulations on your choice of reasons. Can we go now?
Sure.
Good.
Would it be too much to ask where we're going?
Yes, it would be too much.
I thought so.
I've got the biggest jewelry convention and auction in the world staying at my hotel.
Really?
A convention, incidentally, that I stole from New York.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you. Diamonds, emeralds, pearls, everything. I got dignitaries and millionaires floating all over the place. In three of my hotels, I got these prima donnas.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, I have me a sheik, got it?
Yeah.
Who wants to open up his own private casino in my ambassador suite.
Well, that's against the law.
Oh, really?
Expecting trouble? Is that why you brought me along?
More or less.
You know, you've got a security force in six hotels, guys with guns and uniforms, all devoted to you. Why didn't you bring them?
Because if I brought my army, then he'd bring his army, and the next thing you know, we'd have a war.
Huh.
Last one took 6 days, and this one could take a weekend. So I figured I'd bring you along. You know, you can stand near me and be pleasant, but look mean.
Yeah. Well, why don't we share? I'll be pleasant, you be mean. On second thought.
They are perfectly matched. Perfectly cut rules. There are no other like them in the entire world.
Hello.
Legendary Mr. Ross, I believe.
Legendary indeed. I'm at a disadvantage. I don't know the name of the most beautiful girl in the world.
Mrs. Allison Jordan. I'm the Sheik's hostess.
Oh, where is the Sheik?
I'm Dan Tenner. I wasn't, but...
Oh, you are now.
Where is the Sheik?
I think he's a gatecrasher. I met him on the elevator.
Fire. Where is the Sheik?
He's right over there.
Thank you.
Did he really fire you?
It's the second time today.
Ah, Mr. Ross. So nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Tell me, why are the gambling tables not here now? I want them here immediately.
I know you do, and I'm sorry, but the Nevada Gambling Commission does not allow private gambling games in the rooms.
I don't care about the Nevada Commission. Look, I'm immune.
Excuse me, Your Highness. No one's immune. You're not immune. I'm not immune. No one.
I don't care. I say gambling tables, yes!
Sheik? You're checking out.
Kissinger, he ain't.
A toast, gentlemen, to the private tables that Mr. Roth has reserved for the Sheik in the main casino.
Oh, special private tables in the main... Ah, my dear Allison, you are brilliant as usual.
I'm very beautiful.
Mr. Roth.
Please.
I wonder if I might also have some blackjack tables and what you call it?
The Wheel of Fortune?
The Wheel of Fortune.
Yes, of course. I will also give you a bank of slot machines. So while you're waiting for the Wheel of Fortune to pay you off, you'll have something else to play with.
Ah.
Love it, don't you, huh?
Very nice.
Do you like it?
Listen to me. Would you like to come for dinner tonight with us?
Oh, I would love to, but unfortunately I'm busy. But I shall be represented by my aide-de-camp, Mr. Dan Tanner.
Please
do join us.
Okay.
Sure.
Salam, salam, my friend, salam.
Salam.
Thanks so much.
Dan Tanner, you look pretty.
Thank you very much, Beverly. May I use your phone?
Of course. You can use my phone anytime.
Thank you very much. The Princess Suite, please.
Do you mind? Allison?
Mr. Tanner, you're amazingly early.
Very lucky. I thought you might be helping set up the Sheik's party.
No, no, no. I was hostess this afternoon as a special favor to the Sheik.
See, I met him in London a couple of years ago, and since Sheiks rarely travel with any wives, I often do him a favor and help him out with some parties when he comes to this country. I'm off tonight.
Oh, well, in that case, I'm very early and very lonely, and before I start crying and wilt my cummerbund, I need you to hostess my life.
I'm not dressed yet. But I'll meet you in the lobby in 15 minutes.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, bye. Willie, I have to go and meet Tanner before he becomes impatient and comes up here and sees you two.
This place is big enough to hide 10 people. Sure as hell beats that flea bag motel we're staying in.
Yeah, but it's out of the way. You guys aren't exactly unfamiliar faces. Anybody see you come up here?
If they did, they only saw two tourists in sunglasses. Don't even have too far to go to work. I checked the terrace entrance. If the Sheik's lock next door is the same, I can open it with a toothpick.
It's exactly the same.
Are you sure you took the safety off the gas canister?
Is this our first job?
Hey, babe, I don't like you hanging around with a private cop.
The Sheik invited him. Would you rather spend the evening with him yourself?
Hey, you two have been fighting for a month. Now, all I want are the rubies and out of Vegas tomorrow, huh?
All right, look. We'll do everything as usual. You get the package to the desk. We take separate flights out of here tomorrow night. We meet back in New York. And I have to go. Good luck.
Hey, enjoy yourself with Banner. But if he gets in our way, we bury him.
Wild craving for a hot dog and a cold beer.
A hot dog and a cold beer.
Yep.
You got it. Two hot dogs and two cold ones.
I'll never forget you. Amanda, my dear, please, I do not want you to take food that has been on the table more than 4 minutes.
Mrs. Jordan, you are a living, breathing contradiction.
Yeah? How so?
Well, you're sophisticated, you're beautiful, you wear the latest in designer clothes exactly the way they were intended to be worn, your friends are the richest in the world, and you crave hot dogs and beer. And listen to your laugh. It's too healthy. It's too full.
And you don't like it.
I love it.
Good. Just keep me laughing, Dan. Because I need that.
This is very, very nice, but I have one question. Is there, by any chance, a Mr. Jordan?
Not anymore.
Not anymore? Good. Well, in that case, I have five or six dynamite lines guaranteed to work. But if I use one, I'll probably blow it. So, I'm just gonna tell you that I wish there were some place that we could go and be really alone. You know what I mean?
We are alone.
Okay, let me rephrase that to be more alone than we are right now.
Okay, I'm expecting a telephone call.
Yeah.
And as soon as I get it, we'll leave.
Good.
Are your intentions pure?
Are my intentions pure? Well, they're leaning in that direction.
Paging Miss Jordan, Miss Allison Jordan.
Ah.
Be right back. This might be our escape notice.
This just arrived by messenger, and the instructions were to have you paged immediately.
Yes, thank you. It's a watch I was having repaired.
Could you just put it in the hotel safe for me?
Oh, certainly, Mr. Jordan.
Thank you.
Oh, hi.
All obligations completed.
Good.
Where do we go from here?
Well, what about the desert? That's an alone place.
Okay. Anything you say. I'm in your hands. You know something?
What?
I've seen an awful lot of sunrises all over the world. But never have I toasted the birth of a new day in the middle of the desert with a six-pack of beer.
Well, it's not my fault if you lived a deprived life. Just because you've had to stumble along with nothing but limousines and yachts and jet planes.
I'll have you know that I grew up in a small hometown.
Oh, I bet. Where?
Stillwater, Oklahoma. My daddy ran the hardware store.
And how did you end up hobnobbing with the world? Did you strike an oil well in your backyard?
Let's just say that I struck gold in a marriage. He's dead.
Sorry.
Oh, don't be. Time passes and a lot of things happen and, you know.
Good things are bad.
Well, I'm here and I'm happy.
What was that for?
For a lovely evening and a beautiful sunrise. Thank you.
Let's go. What happened? Do you think you can talk and admire at the same time?
You got a Middle East crisis. Them sheep got burglarized.
Oh, no. Who's in the meat wagon?
His bodyguards drugged or something. You sure got a great-looking lady friend.
Yeah, well, I also have a problem.
Are you kidding? She's gorgeous.
I know, if that's why I was with her instead of being here where I should have been.
Hi, Dan.
Is this phone dusted?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm gonna start dressing like a cop.
Is that important?
Beverly, Dan Tanna. Yeah, listen, I need a list of all the hotel guests who've checked out in the last 12 hours. Beverly, I know that, but if Roth calls, he won't say please. Please? Thanks.
Oh, Mr. Tanna, I'm so glad you're here. I just left Mr. Roth. Listen to me. 12 of the most valuable rubies in the world were stolen from this room last night.
Yes, sir, I know.
Now, Mr. Roth insists that you take over the investigation, and so do I, because I don't trust the local police. Now, when can you begin, please?
I've already started.
Good. Mr. Roth guarantees that you will catch the crook.
Now, Mr. Roth guarantees it, does he?
For sure.
Well, Mr. Roth always keeps his word.
Then I take that as a fact.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Come on. Good morning, my dear.
Allison, I'm going to need your help, too. Can you get me a complete list of everybody who was at the cocktail party and last night's dinner?
None of those people were in need of money. I mean, they were all millionaires or better. Except for you.
Well, I have the perfect alibi. I was with you.
Oh, so that means I'm safe, too?
Of suspicion. Until lunch. Is it a date?
Deal.
Okay, I've got to go find those rubies because Roth guaranteed it.
Supposed to stay away from us till you deliver the gems in New York.
I'm not leaving tonight.
What?
I'm not ready to leave.
Why not? How long does it take to pack a bag?
That's not it. I could use a rest. A few days. Won't hurt anything.
We never operated that way before, baby. You know how it is. We do the job and then we pull out the next night. And that's the way it's gonna be now.
Willie, when did you become the boss? And when did you start telling me what I'm going to do and what I'm not going to do?
When you start liking the role you're playing better than your job, then it's time we split.
Well, then you and Marvin split, and I'll be along in a few days.
Willie, it's Dan Tanna. You're hung up on him, aren't you, hon?
I spent one evening with him, and as it turns out, he'll be the best alibi in the world.
Allison, let's get the stones and let's get out of here.
Take them, Willie, and I'll meet you in New York.
No, baby, you always move the stones. Now, Marvin and me, we're not famous, but the cops know us. If we're picked up on a roust, this whole thing will blow wide open.
You'll just have to wait a few days, won't you?
Hey, I do not like this at all.
Me neither.
What do you think?
I think she's got it for this guy, and there's no telling what she might do. I mean, she may not even show up in New York. Maybe the stones don't either.
Then we gotta stay.
Yeah. How many more of those gas canisters we got left?
Four. I stashed them in a locker at the airport. I didn't want to take a chance of having them on me in case I got picked up.
Get them. We're not gonna leave this town until we get rid of Tanna. She won't leave as long as he's alive.
Now, Beverly, you got that list of hotel guests I asked you for?
Everybody that checked out in the last 12 hours? I'm working on it, but the trouble is that two small conventions and a junket checked out, and that's a lot of names.
Beverly, just give me the ones who pay cash.
Well, why just cash?
Private eye, crime stopper tip number one. Good hotel thieves never use checks or credit cards.
Makes sense. Does Roth know how smart you are?
Paging Mr. Tanna.
Please. Tanna.
Damn. I went down to Bella's, like you said. and I got the pictures of all the known jewel thieves in New York, just like you said.
Okay, get out to the airport and keep your eyes open.
I am at the airport. He's here. I got one.
Well, Binzer, why didn't you say so? What's he doing?
Well, he's not doing anything. He's just sitting down.
Well, you do the same thing. I'm on my way.
Okay, fine.
Thanks, Beverly.
Out of New York, he's muscle. He's been arrested enough times to own his own bus route to court. Nothing in the last 2 years, though.
What's his M.O. and who are his known associates?
His M.O. is violence. Let's see, last known associates. Jake Silver out of Jersey.
Nope, he's dead 3 years ago. Who else?
Willie Slater. Now, he was arrested with Marvin on roundups of known criminals twice, in Miami and Puerto Rico. Oh, here's Willie's picture.
Let's see.
Now, we can pick up Marvin for the attempt on you. You find Willie, and I'll figure out something.
Thanks, Bill. And here is the list of the party guests I want you to check in.
Dan, it'll take me 2 hours work for this.
Well, can you make it an hour? I've got a luncheon date, but I'll be back, okay?
Are these all the guests at the Sheik's party?
Everyone except me and Roth.
Well, Roth is clean, but you are what I call a suspect.
Vegas. Either you're too late for lunch or too early for dinner.
Well, it's not my fault. If you hadn't got me that guest list so quickly, I wouldn't have been working this morning.
Oh, do you always work without sleep?
Well, that pays the bills. Almost. just a glass of milk, maybe. Look, I don't want to involve you any further, Allison, but I got to ask you a couple more questions, okay?
Oh, I can be your secret agent.
Yeah. Okay, did the Sheik have any other jewelry or money?
Other than the rubies?
Yeah.
I don't really know.
You don't really know? Are you sure you want to be a secret agent?
I'm not really sure of anything anymore.
Hmm.
I used to be. I had definite plans and schedules. I was even going to leave Vegas tonight.
I was hoping you could stick around a while. Are your plans that important?
I thought they were. They don't seem to be now. I guess I just wanted to hear you ask.
Well, I'll ask again. I want to spend some more time with you. Look, I'll take care of this thing with the Sheik, and then
us secret agents can hide out somewhere and investigate each other.
You might not want to be around me that much.
Maybe not.
I have something to tell you that might scare you. Because it scares me. I think I'm getting hung up on you.
Doesn't scare me a bit. Gonna stay?
The Clyde Carnes were on another party list. They like parties. Also, they are super clean. They squeak. The same for the Duke and the Duchess. Listen, Dan. You know, I've never met any royalty. What are they like, anyhow?
Royalty? What are they like? Well, they're very royal, Bella. What else you got?
Oh, this last name on the list, Allison Jordan.
Yeah?
Well, either you've been smoking something funny or you lost up the spelling.
Well, I might have. Why?
Well, there is no way that she could have been at that party. Because 6 years ago, she and her husband were killed in an automobile accident.
What?
In Europe. Are you sure that's the right name?
You're right. I probably lost the spelling. Thanks, Bella.
She is the most attractive girl that Allison is, she knows.
Thank you. She is very beautiful, very, very much so.
Yes, but you know, I have the feeling that your interest is not part of my case, that it is something personal.
Well, perhaps. Do you know Allison well?
Well. Does a man really ever know a woman well? We look, we admire, we wonder, we think that we know. But, Mr. Tanna, don't fool yourself.
Goatsmoke, very good. Then let me ask this. How long do you not know her?
Hey, I like that. He is beginning to think like one of us. Well, I first met her 2 months ago in London at the ambassador's party. And then 2 weeks later in Paris and several times in your country.
Then you really don't know that much about her.
Well, I know enough for me. I look, I admire. Tell me, does a man really have to know a woman in order to admire looking at her, enjoy being close to her?
I don't really know. Excuse me.
You look tired, my friend. I think perhaps you need to enjoy the magic of our native water park or get some sleep and have some pleasant dreams.
Well, the sleep, definitely. Excuse me.
What about my rubies?
Well, Mr. Roth guaranteed that they would be returned.
Yeah, that he did.
Well, you can take that to be a fact.
I hope so.
Thank you.
Jim Bella. And if I don't tell you right away, I might forget it.
Well, tie a string around your finger, okay? B, would you call Allison Jordan at the DI and tell her that I can't take her out to dinner? And just tell her I'm out of town on business or something. But don't tell her about the accident, all right?
You got it.
Okay, Angie, what is it? Angie, what are you doing?
I'm looking for a piece of string.
B.
Angie, come here. What's the message?
Oh, gee, now what was it? Oh, yeah. Bella said that it was sleeping gas, but she can't match it to the sheet case because she has no samples from that.
Ah, good. B, I have to borrow your car tomorrow, okay?
Sure, Angie can drive me home.
Okay.
And Bella also said that she has an alarm out for Marvin Pace for attempted murder. Did I do good, Dan? Dan?
You did good, Angie. Now drive me home and let's let our little boy get some sleep, okay?
Dana.
Hi. It's a lovely day.
Oh, yeah, right.
We picked up Marvin Pace.
I'll be right down. Thanks, Bella. Beautiful.
Good morning. You got back early.
Yes, and I have the entire day planned out for us. I'm going to pick you up in 1 hour, and we're going to spend the day at Lake Mead.
Sounds exciting. What do you have in mind?
A 50-foot cabin cruiser. I've executed the crew, and we are going to be alone.
You're on. I'll meet you in exactly 60 minutes in front of the hotel.
I make it 59.
Bye.
Instead of going to Lake Mead, I'll tell you that much.
Sit right down there. It'll just take 10 minutes, okay? Be right back.
What are we doing in the police department?
Well, Marvin, now we both have a headache. But you see, there's a difference. Mine's gonna go away in a couple of days with a little rest, some fresh air. And yours is gonna take a couple of years in jail to cure. I wanna show you something.
Okay, what do you want to show me?
Just that I'm taller than you are.
Okay, take him out.
See you, Marvin. He say anything?
You just heard his longest speech of the day. We picked him up coming out of an electronic supply house downtown. These are what he just bought in that store.
What's this?
He had it on him.
Looks like a garage door opener.
Oh, sure, you can open a garage door with it. Or you can activate a detonator that'll explode anything you want.
Including a sleeping gas canister in a car. Really give you a headache. All set.
Let's be sensible. You're hurt, you need some rest, so rather than go to the lake, let's just meet for dinner.
Good idea. I'll drop you off at the hotel.
Okay.
Who is that that man in handcuffs down at the police station?
He's a jewel thief. He's the one who gave me this headache.
What do you think they'll do to him?
They'll lock him up for a long time unless we can persuade him to help us out with some information.
You think he will?
He's smart. I think he will. I'll pick you up at 6.
This is Allison. Marvin has been arrested.
What for?
For trying to kill Dan Tanna. I told you to stay away from him.
That's not important now.
Look, you'll have to make the arrangements for the lawyer and the bail. We can't do that here. You'll have to go through our New York lawyer.
If you hadn't fallen for that Tanna guy, we'd have been out of here yesterday, and Marvin wouldn't be in this hassle.
It was you who gave those orders on Tanna, and that's why Marvin's in this hassle.
Okay, we'll hash that out later.
There's a plane out of here at 3:45. You better be there with the rubies. That's it, Allison. Be there.
Thank you. Mind if I come in? I wasn't invited.
You're always invited. Why'd you come back? And when are you gonna get some sleep?
Oh, I remembered I had to talk to the Sheik. You know, he's really an okay guy. In an offbeat kind of a way. He's got no axe to grind, no grudges. All the man wants is his rubies back. No complaints. No police, no charges.
And you'd handle it just like that?
Well, then I'd be finished with this case. I have all the time I'd need to fall in love with this complicated lady I've met. Then there'd be no reason not to.
Can it really be that simple, Dan? Is anything that easy?
Maybe, maybe not, I don't know. I could probably work it out. Something I want to work out.
Look, it's 12 o'clock. Why don't you go home and get some sleep, and by the time you come back and pick me up for dinner, maybe this whole thing will be resolved. I really think it will be resolved.
And we got till tonight for Lady Luck to take charge of our lives.
Dan, I'm the lucky lady. I'm sorry.
So am I.
Now, what are you doing here? You don't drink.
Well, I thought it was about time I learned.
Oh, really? Well, it looks like you're doing it all wrong. I'm an expert. I'll teach you, okay?
Oh, good.
Let me show you. Now, for openers, I gotta see your technique. Salute. Now. I was right. You're doing it all wrong. You can't jolt at it, you know. You gotta get it past the taste buds. You've gotta let it roll down over your tongue. Here, try it again.
So look, you're an amazing guy.
I know it.
You own this town, yet you sit here and waste your time with me.
I'm sitting here with a friend.
Well, I really appreciate that. You're all right, you know that.
If you kiss me, I'll get you arrested. I've got a reputation to uphold.
Call the cops.